Hello, welcome back to the channel. If you are working in sustainability and you would like to know if you can get the support of AI agents for your project, you'll find the right video. My name is Samir. I'm supply chain data scientist and founder of the startup LogiGreen. Over the past 4 months, we have been experimenting the usage of AI agents to improve our processes, but also to support the green transformation of our customers. In this video, I will introduce 4 different agents that are covering multiple topics,
from marketing and content creation to CSRD report audit.
We also cover ESG reporting analysis. And finally, I will introduce you a tool that we are using to monitor the discussions in the European Parliament regarding sustainability. For that, I'm using the tool NNN. If you are not familiar with this tool, it's a no-code tool that helps you to build workflow automation without writing a single line of code. Now let's dive in the different agents to show you basically how you can use AI to improve your productivity and to make companies more sustainable. First, I would like to start with this AI agent that I developed for marketing and content creation. So as sustainability professionals, one of the great ways to impact is to bring awareness to people and businesses. And for that, we can create content online. I have my blog since 2020 and I have this YouTube channel, but I know that it's extremely difficult to start. So one of the good ways that would advise you to start is basically instead of creating your own articles, you can provide a curated list of good articles. And for that, you can use NNN and AI to do it fully automatically. So how does it work? First, maybe let me show you the source. So here, for the sake of simplicity, I only take one source, but in my real workflow, we have like multiple sources. But here we take the European Commission, which is a good source. They publish on a daily basis articles related to multiple topics. And the workflow that I designed using AI is extracting the information of these articles, filtering by topics, and then storing that in a Google Sheet, and then sending a kind of a beautiful email with all the different articles to my audience in my newsletter. It's fully automatic and I will show you how it's working. So let's go back to the workflow. So I won't enter in the details of the notes, but you can find in the video description a complete tutorial on how to set up, how to change the parameters so you can deploy this workflow on your machine and adapt it to your needs. So basically here we have a trigger at 8:30 a.m. Paris time because we are based in Paris. We extract all the articles from the website and then these nodes do some cleaning. Here we only filter the articles that are published yesterday. And then we loop over the different articles. And this is here where you have the AI agent. We provide to the AI agent, and let me go back to the website. We provide the title and we provide the description. And then we ask the agent if it's related to sustainability or not. So let me show you the prompt. So here we have the system prompt telling the agent that he's a classification assistant and that we are going to provide him the title and the description. And then he needs to provide the answer if it's sustainability, if the article is related to sustainability or not. What we make sure here is that we have the right format, but I will provide more details in the tutorial. And then we use the output, we use the flag, we add the flag to the other information of the article, so like the title, the description, and the link, and then we store that in the Google Sheet. And then after it's done, after we have stored all the articles, we are extracting, downloading these articles, and generate a beautiful email that is sent to our list. So it looks a bit theoretical. Let me run the workflow so you can see it working. So here, what we could see is that it was very fast to extract the information. Now we are looping over the different articles. As you can see here that we have 5 items, so 5 articles. It's done. So now we load these 5 articles, we generate the email in HTML format, and we send the email. So how does it look like? Great. So this is the email. And as you can see, so here, that's what I have put in the code node where I basically built the page, the HTML page. So I call that the EU News Digest. Here you have the date of today. Today we are the 17th of April. Here, a very small link to my website. Let's not forget, this is a marketing tool. So maybe let me zoom in a bit. This is a marketing tool. So we use that to provide some traffic to our website and potential new opportunities. And here, as you can see, is that the format looks like the same, maybe an improved version of it. But here, you only have the articles that are related to sustainability. So here we're talking about like climate report. Here we were talking about climate coalition, fusion. So here we're talking about energy. Here we are talking about high-speed rail. That's, I don't know if it's related or not. Maybe it's clean transportation. But this is where probably that you can adapt the prompt if you don't consider, for instance, these are topics related to sustainability. And here we talk about climate resilience. And as you can see, it's done automatically. So here I click the button for the example. But then when the workflow is set up, this will be automatically sent to all your audience without you putting a single effort on changing parameters or something. So it's working pretty well. I did that for sustainability. You can do that for any other topics. But that's one of the first example of AI agent that I'm using. So now let's go to the other example. So the second agent here is more related to ESG scoring. For one project, I've been contacted by an ESG analyst that needed my support to create a tool that would automatically monitor the ESG score of a list of 100 large companies. So these companies that are publicly listed share their ESG score on public platforms. And the idea was to extract this information and then, based on the score, sending or not alerts to him or his manager. So let me show you how it's working. First, what's the source? So here the source is Yahoo Finance. And for most of the listed company, you can have the ESG ratings. You have some risk score, some controversy levels, and then some information that would impact this ESG scoring. And the idea was to, on a regular basis, to automatically scrape the data from the website. If I go back to the workflow, ask an AI agent to create a report that would be in the form of HTML. And then this report will be analyzed by a large language model to understand what is the sentiment, if it's positive, neutral, or negative. If it's positive or neutral, we'll be sent the report to the manager. It would be without any like mention that is urgent or not. It's just for information, I would say. If it's neutral, we record the neutral scores in the Google Sheet, because the ESG analyst would then look at it to perform some analysis. And if it's negative, probably something needs to be done, a kind of a deeper research. Then I create a Google task in the calendar of the analyst. So he can have a look every morning at all the different companies that he has to study. So it looks like a bit theoretical. Let me launch the workflow so you can see. So here are the workflow that we are launching. So the first block, loading the page, extracting the information. So here we need to render the JavaScript, so it takes a bit of a time. Then what we can see is the agent now got all the scoring, right? All the information, and it will generate the output. So in terms of scoring, we have the ES and G scores with the controversy level. I think we provide also what are the involvements of the company. And here, yeah, this is the results where you have the report generated in HTML format. Why in HTML format? Because we are going to send this by email. And then we have the sentiment analysis. So the sentiment analysis is taking by the output, the report, and then analyze the sentiment if it's neutral, negative, and here's or positive, here's neutral. So because it's neutral, we are recording that in the Google Sheet and we are sending the email. Let me show you that. So, ESG scoring is here, yeah. So as you could see, well, I did several tests for the video, but that's the results of the Tesla stock. So here we have studied the Tesla stock. So we are recording all the informations. And then if I check my emails, yeah, I receive a new email and here is the report. It's pretty easy, it's automatic. Not a single line of code has been written. The only probably difficulty is on how to extract the right information, the right content. You can replicate that in your instance by copying the templates that would be shared in the tutorial linked in the description. And then you can launch that for your analysis. The only thing that you have to change is, of course, the way that you want to have the AI agents to react. But that's quite efficient for the analyst, because now So this is not the actual workflow. The actual workflow is a bit more complex, but the actual workflow includes up to 50 companies. It's run every month, and every month notification for the stocks that he has to study more deeper. So it takes, and instead of manually checking the websites, now he can just rely on the workflow here with the AI agent. And as everything is recorded, he can also check if sometimes the AI agent made a mistake. Okay, I think it's good for this one. Let's move to the other one. Great, so now we arrive at the third agent. And this one is probably one of my favorite. So for sustainability reporting, at least in Europe, we have the Corporate Sustainability Reporting Directive. And one of the main impacts for companies is that they have to prepare a report following a certain template. And this template looks like this. So it's in XHTML format, and you have multiple information related to the ESG score, the life cycle assessment. And it, for some companies, the companies that are maybe less mature in terms of data analytics, it can be a challenge to format these reports in the correct way. Therefore, I have designed this workflow. So let's imagine that I will go back here. Let's imagine that you have prepared a report. So here I have this example of the invalid report. You send that to the bot, so the Logic Green bot. Here in the topics, in the subject, you make sure that you are putting CSRD reporting. And here I have put the name of the company. So I took Total, it's a complete random example. What happened? So maybe let me launch it. Yeah, so the email is sent, so the trigger is triggered. So here we just check on that it's related to reporting. And then we download, so the workflow is downloading the attachment, performing some data processing to check if the report is correct. So it's looking at the format, it's looking at missing values. And then this AI agent will take the output. So here, for instance, this is the output of the audit that was generated by the code, and where you have different informations, and it will send. But this information may sometimes be not, I would say, understandable for someone that is not technical. Therefore, we are using this AI agent to send a proper email in plain English, where all the information I used to generate a kind of a summary. And this summary is sent back to the sender. So if I show you on my mailbox how it looks like, so here, what we could see is that we send to ourselves the report, and here we have the results. And what kind of results we have? So we provide so it's introducing the topic, the key findings, and what is very interesting is here that we have a kind of a summary. Here is just a kind of a listing of the different information that were generated by the report analytics section, like the two blocks of code in the workflow. And here what we are, and here's a kind of a summary with recommendation. So as you could see, it took less than a minute to do that. And it could be, you can use this workflow to generate a kind of a audit check as a service, where you send to an email, it could be a Slack, it could be a Telegram bot, you know, with N8N, you can have any interface. And this workflow would help to analyze the content of the reports and make sure that the reports are compliant. And it was pretty easy. Of course, you can find in the description the complete tutorial with the template provided. So you can copy and paste the template in your instance. And with the tutorial, you can know how you adapt the different parameters so you can run it yourself. The changes that you have to do, it's explained in the tutorial, are mainly the user prompt and the system message. But it takes maybe like less than 5 minutes to set it up for you, and then it's ready to be used. So now we can move to the last one. Here is the last agent that I wanted to introduce to you, and probably the one that has the biggest impact internally for us. So for the context, we are working in sustainability. We are based in Paris. One of the main factors that would influence our activity is the regulation. So therefore, this is our duty for us, but also for our customers, to monitor what are the different discussions in the European Union, as it may impact our activity or the portfolio of services that we provide to companies. Therefore, we have developed this agent. So what this agent is doing? It's Currently monitoring this website, the Legislative Observatory of the European Union, of the Parliament, that where you can find every day all, like a kind of reports of all the discussions that happened during the day in the Parliament. For each discussion, you have a code. Sometimes you have a category. So here, for instance, about international trade. You have a rapporteur, so it's like someone in charge of the discussion. I guess I'm not an expert in that. You have a short description, and then you have the date and the action behind, if it's a debate, if it's a decision. And you have the link, like a PDF for more details. And the idea is that we have created an initial workflow that would scrape all the information and that would send that to our legal expert. The problem was that she was receiving, because here, for instance, you have 23 results. She was doing that on a daily basis. So if you multiply that by 5, it would be like more than 100, right? So we have improved the workflow to include AI. So AI would filter out all the topics that are not related to sustainability. So it looks like a bit theoretical. So let me show you in real. So I launched the report, the workflow. So here, the first block, it's mainly to extract information and to parse the right parameters that we want to use for our workflow. Here, so we have like 21 items, so 21 like articles. We are not articles, but more like, reports or let's call that items. We are looping over these items. And the idea here is for each item, we are using the classification agent. So this agent will take all the information available, but mainly here, the title, the description, and sometimes the committee, if we have it, to assess if it's related to sustainability or not. If it's related to sustainability, we record that in a Google Sheet and we create a Google task. So now the workflow is done. Let me show you the results. So here, I think it's for that date. First, in terms of recording, so we have recorded all these information, all these items. So here, I think I launched it 2 times for the demo, so I can delete these rows. And here, as we can see, we have 4 items, and they all look like to be related to sustainability. So the agent did a good job. And then if we go look at the tasks, yeah, we have 4 tasks. And each task you have the title, the reference number, the committee, and more importantly, the link. So it's automatic. So here I launch it manually, but what we do is we launch it on a daily basis. So we do that every morning for the day before. And everything is recorded in the Google task of our legal experts. So then she just have to check the to-do list of all the different documents that she has to analyze. And actually what she's doing, she's using another workflow that is still work in progress, that digests all the documents and create a kind of a summary. So then she just have to check that the summary is correct. We are still in calibration. And then she can send us back the summary. So here, we are basically automatically monitoring the regulation without impacting our productivity using AI. To conclude, I shared with you a sample of the type of applications of AI that we are using to improve our productivity for all the sustainability projects that we are involved. It was mainly related on content creation, regulation, and ESG scoring. We have other applications that are a bit more confidential because we are implementing that for our customers. But that gives you an idea of what you can do to improve your productivity and efficiency while working on sustainability. So if you want more details about that, don't hesitate to check the other videos in my channel. Don't hesitate to subscribe. I will publish many videos in the coming weeks and months. And if you have any question, feel free to use the comment section. I will answer all of them. Thank you.